Today, I'm going to demystify what 3D projection mapping really is. I'm going to show you the basics of 3D projection mapping, how content is created, how projection mapping software works under the hood, and some really neat things that we can do with 3D projection mapping. This video is a part of a series on the channel about projection mapping. Check out this playlist here if you want to learn the very basics. Let's start off simple and look at a cube. Let's look how we would start projection mapping this cube. From 2D projection mapping, we've learned that we can use what are called surfaces to map on a flat two-dimensional shape. And you can see a cube has a square. But the problem with three-dimensional shapes is that they have a lot of faces or surfaces. And for example, this cube has six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We don't want to have to make content for each one of the surfaces, and we don't want to have to individually map each surface in QLab or whatever software we're using. We're going to use a technique to unwrap this object so that we're able to treat it as one surface and then let our projection mapping software rewrap it back onto the 3D object when we go to present. The unwrapping process is pretty simple. We take the three-dimensional object and we cut it at all the seams and we lay it flat. So for a cube, that's going to look like this. We are then able to come along and paint and do whatever art we want on our object. For example, we could come and we can make each surface its own color. Now all we have to do is fold this back up until it's a 3D object again. There we go. We now see that we have a cube with each of the surfaces a different color. Great. Now that we know conceptually what we need to do, let's hop on over to the computer and briefly see how we would start making projection content. Let's go ahead now and prepare some content for projection mapping. I have opened a program called Blender 3D, which is an amazing open source software that allows us to do pretty much anything 3D. I already have the cube in here, and we're going to now make some content for it. I'm just going to click on the cube, and I'm going to go up to texture painting. And this is going to be a very, very simple example. I'm not going to go into any detail about how to create content. This is just more for concepts. And you'll see that we have this cube here. And then on the left-hand side, you'll see that this looks a lot like what we did before when we took our cube and we unwrapped it. This is the unwrapped view. So what I'm going to need to do first is create a texture. And now you will see that the cube is now dark. And I'm going to open that texture up here. And zoom out a bit. And so now we can simply select a color. I will go blue and I'll put a happy face. And you can see as we draw on the cube, it will show up on our unwrapped texture over here. Likewise, I can also go over to the unwrapped version and I can draw right on here, and as I do, it will show up here in the 3D view. After you finish making your content in whatever 3D software of your choices, this is what we're going to need, this image right here of the unwrapped texture, and this is what we're going to put into our projection mapping software, and then it's going to take it and wrap it around our 3D object once again. That's great! We now have our projection content. Even though all projection mapping software programs differ slightly, they all follow the same basic steps. First, we need to import the 3D model of the objects that we are going to be projection mapping onto and drop them into our scene. Next, we need to import the projection mapping content we created in the last section. Finally, we simply need to drop the content onto the object to assign it. Let's now take a look at what happens inside of the projection mapping software. All a 3D projection mapping software does is creates a 3D environment where we have the objects we want to projection map onto and cameras positioned at the same vantage point as where the projector is in the real world. Let's hop back onto the computer and I'll show you. If we were to look inside at our projection mapping software, we would see something that kind of looks like this. On the left-hand side, we have a scene view, which houses all of the 3D objects, as well as a camera. In this camera, we would point at the object that we want to projection map on. This camera would capture the scene and create an output that we then plug into our projector. Right now everything is dark since I've not assigned a texture to this cube. I'm going to go ahead and use a free texture I found on the internet, and I'm going to drag that onto the cube. So now you can see we have a marble cube. Now, all we have to do is select our camera, and we need to move this around until it matches where our projector is in the 3D space. Great, now that we got everything positioned, we can see that we would be sending this signal to the projector. It will be dark everywhere where there's nothing to project on, and this virtual cube will align exactly to where the real cube is in our world. And with that, we've successfully projection mapped a cube. But what if we want to have a more complex object? Here's a vase that I found a file for online and 3D printed. I'll go ahead and leave a link in the description if you'd like to download this yourself. And it basically, you can see as I turn it, there's lots of little shiny reflections, and those are all surfaces. And of course, in traditional QLab sense, we could come in and we could create each one of these as its own surface, and then create our content and map our content to each one of these surfaces like that. But as you can see, we would quickly rack up a lot of surfaces, and we would not want to do that approach. We could with a cube, but we can't do it for complex objects like this. So we're going to need to turn to our computer to help us out with the content creation. To create content for more complex objects, the process is the exact same as we did with the cube. We simply have to unwrap the object and create content for it. Or we can use the same 3D software to render out a cool looking texture. That's pretty much how 3D projection mapping works. If you are interested in 3D projection mapping, stay tuned for my next video where I will use real-time 3D rendering and external sensors to create an interactive 3D projection design. If you found this video useful, feel free to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to support the channel. And I will see you next time.